You know, one of the great disappointments of this pandemic has been our inability to see some of the great young talent of stage and screen. Actress and singer Lucy Durack is one of those magnificent performers we've missed in 2020. A graduate of the famous West Australian Dramatic Art Institute, WAPPA, it didn't take long for Lucy to score lead roles in productions such as Wicked and Legally Blonde, while being the go-to star for a number of TV dramas as well. Lucy Durack's in lockdown, but joins us on the virtual couch. Lucy, welcome to the program.
Thank you very much. Thanks for having me.
How are you feeling in lockdown in Melbourne, and what have you and the family been doing to fill in the time, you poor sods?
Look, we're doing our best. I've got a one-year-old and a five-year-old, and my husband, amongst many other things, is a choreographer and also a tap dance teacher. So he flew to Sydney to choreograph a television show there for a while, so I was in lockdown on my own with the kids, which was an interesting experience. But he's been doing a lot of tap dancing teaching, so he's got this tap board that he does all of the teaching that he'd normally do for VCA and various places, but out of my daughter's bedroom, because it's the quietest place in the house so that my son can still nap.
Right.
And I wrote a web series called Love in Lockdown right at the start of the first lockdown when it was all kind of novel. And Robin Butler and Wayne Hope made it with their company Gristmill, and they of course make like Upper Middle Bogan and shows like that. And it was super fun, and we got Eddie Perfect involved, and he and I did this kind of iPhone rom-com during, it was a series of ukulele lessons. So we've kept ourselves pretty busy.
You're busy, all right, but for the rest of the industry, it's been an absolute nightmare, hasn't it?
Oh, it has. It has been incredibly sad. I was lucky enough at the time to be playing Princess Fiona in the musical Shrek, and we were at the Madge in Melbourne when COVID hit and everything was shut down. And yeah, it has been absolutely devastating for so many people, and a lot of people have had to pivot into other industries and try to make ends meet in however they possibly can, because of course there's absolutely no live theatre, of course, in Melbourne. Frozen is about to start rehearsals in Sydney, which is very exciting and promising. I'm not entirely sure how they're going to go about it, but I'm sure it'll be a kind of a new way of being in an audience.
So an audience to concerts and also to theatrical performances, there'll be what, social distancing in the seats in the audience? Is that how you imagine it?
I think so. Yeah, I think that I imagine people will be perhaps more distant from each other, perhaps wearing masks. I imagine there'll be lots of hand sanitizer stations. That's what I'm imagining, but I don't know that for sure. But I think that we're going to have to all get used to being close to each other. You know, I watch a television show and everybody's close and not wearing masks. Well, that's from something that was filmed pre-COVID. And I think, what are you doing? Move away from each other. That's very dangerous behaviour. So I think we're going to have to really start, you know, rethink and retrain ourselves to be out in social settings and places like the theatre, because I think it's really important. You know, we need the arts to kind of process what's happened to us as a world.
Yeah.
And I'm very much looking forward to being in the audience of something myself.
Let's remind... Whenever that may be. Let's remind...